मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज प्रीति मोरे एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टूडेज यूट्यूब वीडियो. टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी आर चैप्टर 4. एक्चुअली वी इन द लास्ट वीडियो ओनली वी हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर 24, द स्टोरी ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. एंड वॉट वी हैव सीन इन दैट डेमोक्रेसी, वी हैव जस्ट सीन वॉट इज डेमोक्रेसी. सो द डेमोक्रेसी इज एक्चुअली, डेमोक्रेसी मीन्स द रूल ऑफ द पीपल. अ वेरी फेमस कोट बाय अब्राहम लिंकन डिस्क्राइब द डेमोक्रेसी एज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द पीपल. सो इन बेसिकली द डेमोक्रेसी इज द रूल ऑफ द पीपल. एंड वॉट वी हैव कवर्ड इन द लास्ट वीडियो, द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द डेमोक्रेसी, हाउ द डेमोक्रेसी बर्थ इन ग्रीस एंड हाउ इट्स डेवलप्ड डे बाय डे एंड हाउ इट्स टुक द प्लेस इन द वेरियस कंट्रीज एंड हाउ द डेमोक्रेसी अडोप्टेड बाय द वेरियस कंट्रीज. नाउ द यूरोप इन द मिडल एज, दिस ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन द रेनेसांस, दिस ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन इन द लास्ट वीडियो. नाउ टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द डेमोक्रेसी इन इंग्लैंड, हाउ वॉज द डेमोक्रेसी इन द इंग्लैंड एंड हाउ इट वॉज डेवलप्ड ओवर देयर. सो यू ऑल्सो ओपन योर पेज नंबर 185 एंड देर इज द डेमोक्रेसी इन इंग्लैंड. अ सिग्निफिकेंट माइल स्टोन इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द डेमोक्रेसी वॉज अ डॉक्यूमेंट कॉल्ड The Magna Carta, which was passed in the 1215 CE in England. Now, there was in England the time to adopt the democracy. So there was one document, and the document name was the Magna Carta, which was passed in the 1215 CE in England. That document was passed in the year 1215 CE in England, and it paved the way for the creation of a law-making body called Parliament. Now, that document made a strong way for the creation of the law-making. That Marta. Magna Carta, this document made the strong way for accepting the new law making procedure, and it was called the Parliament. The noble of the England forced the resigning monarch of the time, King John, to sign this historic document, which state that written law held a higher power than the king. Now the people of England, they forced that king, and the king, who was the king that time? The king name was King John, and everyone forced, all the people forced the king to sign that document, because this document was very important and that document has very great power than the king. So all the peoples of the England forced the king to sign that documents. State that written law held a higher power than the king, and that document there was written the higher power, and many rules and regulation and many things were written in that documents, and the people of the England were forcing to the king to sign that document, because in that time the king of the England were ruling over the England, but the people don't want the king ruling over them. So they just want some rules and some laws should be there, it is in the written, and king had to be sign it. So all the peoples were just forcing king to sign that document, and that document name was the Magna Carta. The king influenced the parliament increased gradually. The power of the monarch were further curtailed by the petition of right and the English bill of the right. Then when that bill was passed in the parliament, that time the king's power were curtailed there. मतलब किंग की पावर तब कम हो गई थी, बिकॉज द इम्पोर्टेंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स वॉज पास्ड ओवर देयर एंड दैट डॉक्यूमेंट हैड द ग्रेट पावर दैन द किंग. सो वेन दैट डॉक्यूमेंट पास देयर, दैट टाइम द किंग्स पावर वेयर कल्टेल्ड बाय द पेटिशन ऑफ द राइट एंड द इंग्लिश बिल ऑफ द राइट. वाइल द फॉर्मर ensured that the king could not impose taxes without the permission of the parliament. So what that document, when that document was passed, so they put the name of that document was Parliament, and the king powers were declined that time, and king has no power. He could not impose the taxes without taking permission of the Parliament. That means here the Parliament has a great power than the king, and without permission of the Parliament, king could not do anything, and even he could not impose the taxes over the people. Latter expanded the scope of the freedom and of speech of the expression. When after passing the documents, after passing the Magna Carta that in Parliament, so there was the speaking freedom and the expression freedom was also developed over there. That means all the people was having the right to speak and to express their thought. So the scope of the freedom of speech and expression was expanded over there. These steps were the significant as they diminished the power of the king. Then as soon as that power, that the Parliament power were increased in all over the England, that time the king's power were totally diminished. The idea that diminished means destroyed. The idea that the king was not all powerful and was uncountable to an elected body of representative was born. So here then the England expected the England adopted the power of the Parliament rather than the power of the king. So everyone in the England, they just tried to accept the rules and law making decision of the Parliament, and they stopped because the king's power were already declined after after passing this Parliament. So the all the peoples have got the opportunity to speak, the freedom of speaking and the freedom of expressions. So here the democracy in England, we have seen first the king was ruling in England, but later there was the Parliament who has the great power than the king. Now the American Revolution. In England, democracy in England we have seen. Now we'll see the American Revolution. What was there in American Revolution? The American Revolution. In the 18th century, America fought to free himself from the compressive and the exploitative. Compressive means atyachari, that means slavery, and exploitation means shoshan. So in the 18th century, America fought to free itself from the oppressive and the exploitative British rule. First, who was ruling on the America? British was ruling on the America, and then America fought to free itself. They fought with America to free itself from the oppressive and the exploitative British rule. Now let's see the American Revolution. First, the British was ruling on America. Later, the America was fought themselves for to free from the oppressive and the exploitative British rule. The concept of democracy received a further boost after the American War of the Independence in 1776. The concept of democracy received a further boost. That means in America, they received the democracy after a war of the independence. After the war of, that means America and British had a war, and after that war, they got, America got the independence in 1776. The Declaration of Independence written by one of the founding fathers of America. That means there was one definition was written of the written one of the founding father of America. So America made free itself from the British rule and they got independence in the 1776. And one famous father of America, Thomas Jefferson, has declared that all men are created equal and have the right to life, liberty and pursuit of happiness. So what the Thomas Jefferson written? It declared that all the men are created equal. That means all the human beings are equal. All the humans being are having the same right and they have right to be happy and they have right to do everything by their own. A written constitution was adopted in 1789 and a federal government based on the division of power was established in the United States of America. Then in 1789 they adopted the federal government. What they founded, they adopted the federal government based of the division of the power was established in United States America. Here America adopted the democracy. A Bill of Rights was the passed in 1792. Then the Bill of Rights, that means there was some in the constitution there was written the rights, Bill of Rights, the law, how to make the law and some rules and regulation, how to run the government of the America. This everything was written in that Bill of Rights. So that Bill of Rights was passed in 1792, which provided for an elected government and guaranteed certain rights to its citizen under the law. Now the French Revolution. So in the America also they adopted the democracy and that bill was passed in 1792. So and the famous Thomas Jefferson declared that all the men and women has the power of equality and they have right to life, liberty and pursued the happiness. So here we have just seen the democracy in England and the American Revolution. Now let's see the French Revolution. What is there in the French Revolution? The French Revolution of 1789 marked a turning point in the journey of democracy. Now what in the French Revolution 1789 marked a turning point? It was the turning point. This year 1789, this was the turning point in the journey of democracy. The people of France were divided into three states. That time, the 1789, this year was the turning point for the French Revolution, and there was three category of the people, and France has divided that people in the three category. What that category was? The first state considered of the clergy, that means clergy means it was the category of the peoples who were rich. The second was state considered the nobility, and the second was little middle class people. First class was the rich, the second was the middle class, and the third state considered of the common people, and third was the common people. So in the French Revolution 1789, this was the landmark and it was the turning point of the French, and the French and the people of the France were divided in three category. The people were France divided in three category. First category was clergy, second category was nobility, and the third category was the common people. While the clergy and the noble enjoyed all the privileges, the common people were not entitled to any, had to pay the heavy taxes. Then the first class people and the second class people, the clergy and nobility, these people were enjoying their freedom, they were enjoying their privileges, but the common people had to pay a heavy taxes. Only it was the it was not fair with the common people, and this was the third state of the France people. So the revolution with its slogan of liberty, equality and fraternity was directed against the clergy and the nobles. Now what the then the slogan was there just for the common people, because the third class was of the common people. The first class people, the clergy and the nobility, these two class were already enjoying their freedom and they were already enjoying their privileges. But the common people were not having any right and they just had to pay the heavy taxes. So what happened here? The revolution with its slogan of liberty, equality and fraternity was directed against the clergy and the noble. Then there was one slogan established over there for the equality and the fraternity, and this equality and fraternity, this slogan was totally against the clergy and the nobles people. On 17 June 1789, the third estate declared itself as a national assembly. So the third estate was who? The common people. So 1789, the common people declared as the national assembly themselves. They fought for themselves, the third estate, the common people fought itself and they declare themselves as a national assembly. In August 1789, it adopted the Declaration of the Rights of Man and the Citizen. So in France, the Declaration of the Right and the Man of the Citizen. So they adopted in the France, then because the third people was who? The common people. They fought for themselves, because they in the initial days the people of France has divided in three categories. First class was clergy, second was nobility and third was the common. But the first and the second class people were already enjoying their liberty and privileges, but the common people had not any right to say something. They don't had any right to live the life, and even they had to pay more taxes. So the common people, the third estate, they found themselves and they declared themselves as a national assembly, and they adopted the right of man and the citizen. It declared that all men are born free and have equal rights. Then they declare that all the human beings, they born free and have equal rights. It gave people the right to liberty. Then they adopted the right of man and the citizen. So in that bill, it gave the people the right to liberty, equality and fraternity. A constitution was framed and it came into force in 1791. So in the 1791, the constitution was adopted by the France, and the French Revolution was the landmark in the history of democracy. First, there was some category of the people, first class, second class and third class, but the third class people, the common people, they fought for themselves, they declared themselves as a national assembly. Even they made some rules and they made some slogan that everyone has a equal power and everyone has born free and have equal rights. Then later, the France has adopted the democracy. And the French Revolution was the landmark in the history of democracy. So the French become the landmark history of democracy. It marked the end of absolute monarchy and the established in the principle of self-government. So the France made itself government by adopting the democracy. It strengthened the idea that people are supreme and laid foundation of a democratic government. So what happened here? The idea that people are supreme. So here it was become the landmark French French Revolution was the landmark history of the democracy and they adopted the democracy in year 1791 and it strengthened and it developed that French France and the strengthened the idea of the people are the supreme. So they just gave all the right to the common people also, and the people are the supreme and laid the foundation of democracy government. A series of revolutions swept Europe in 19th century as people demanded greater rights and participation in the government. So in the 19th century people asked to participate in the government. They asked, the people demanded greater rights and the participation in the government. So the common people was asked to participation in the government and they asked for the greater rights. By the end of the 19th century, almost all the government had adopted various form of the constitution. So all the government had here adopted in the 19th century, almost all the government, America, England, France, this all the government had adopted the democracy and form of the constitution that limited the power of the monarch. So here we have seen the democracy in India, the American Revolution, the French Revolution. Now let's see the march to democracy. Now the march to democracy, it is what is written there, the march to democracy. As the voice was democracy grew louder, more development took place worldwide in 20th century. So in the 20th, all the countries has adopted the democracy and different constitution was made by their government. So once the democracy was accepted, the democracy grew louder and more development took the place in the various countries. The woman suffrage movement gained pace with women demanding the right to vote. First, the woman has no power to vote, but in the 20th century, the woman has got right to vote also in the government to choose their leader. So the woman also had got right to vote. In 1893, New Zealand became the first country to grant universal adult franchise. So you just underline that line. The New Zealand became the first country to grant universal adult franchise. All over the world, the colonized countries began nationalist struggle to throw off the shackles of colonialism. So here in all the countries where the woman has no right, but after the New Zealand become the first country to grant the universal adult franchise, then the all countries had given the right to the woman also. After the end of the Second World War in 1945, the decolonization and the civil rights movement took place all over the world. Then after the Second World War in 1945, the civil rights movements took the place all over the world. That means the common people, all the people have the right to elect their leader and they have all the equal rights to live their life. So many countries in Asia, Africa and South America declare their independence. Then after the Second World War, many countries of Asia, Africa and South America declare their independence. Constitution were adopted in these countries. Then constitution was also adopted there. That means the king and queen method was not there. Now the constitution democracy was adopted in all the countries of Asia, Africa and South America. Constitution were adopted in these countries that prescribe the power of the government and enshrined the right of the people. So the countries that prescribe the power of the government in the constitution, there was the power of the government and what is the right of the common people, this was also written over there. The Declaration of the Human Rights 1948, the culmination of a long struggle for the human dignity, was signed by the most countries of the right. So most of the countries have adopted had adopted the democracy and they run their country by the constitution. So here we have seen the democracy in England, the American Revolution, the French Revolution and the March to the Democracy. So in the March to the Democracy, women also got the right to elect their own leader and all the common people have common people has given many rights to live the life, to expression and to freedom, and human dignity was also written over in the constitution. So what is your homework? The glossary you have to note down in your notebook. Write down the glossary of the chapter. This is your homework and this lesson is there for your test. So it was our first priority to complete this lesson. Yesterday we have completed half and today we have completed the full lesson. So you have to do all the question answers you have been already provided. So there was no worry about the question answer, but the glossary you have to write in your notebook. So we'll meet soon in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care and thank you.